from what we can tell, it seems that volcanic activity on Reykjanes happens in pulses. So yeah, 800 years ago, there was a series of eruptions that took place all along Reykjanes at different times, one after the other, with some significant time in between, like decades. And so in 2021, we had the first eruption since medieval times. But in fact, in 2020, there was an intrusion detected underneath Thorbjörn. So potentially that was the start of this new episode. We had had this intrusion going on just north of Thorbjörn in this area here, and we could see this inflation going on in the GPS, and so this is saying that the ground is moving up with time, and then this dramatic shift is the evening of the 10th of November, and what we can see here is that the ground has dropped by around 40 centimeters. But crucially, the signal of inflation has continued without pause.
This process is going on for millions of years. One of the largest plate boundary of this type is running along the whole Atlantic. On a divergent plate boundary, you are dragging the plates away from each other. Iceland is the only place on Earth where this plate boundary comes out of the sea. So what we are trying to understand is what lies behind the volcanoes, how the magma comes up to surface and how it spreads on surface. Today, we can only forecast 2-3 days into the future. In the current unrest on Reykjanes, we can say that there are probably 80% probability that we will have an eruption, but we don't know when it's going to be. And yet, we cannot nail down where it's going to be. This action that we are dealing with now will probably be ongoing for the next 10 years. We are going to see breaking along the whole peninsula for the next 100 to 300 years.